backbone and junior, number 5, Ben Sampson.
For the players that are fantastic, soccer players, you know, academics might be an area that they struggle, and the same the other way around. For some players that are fantastic academically, maybe getting some time on the field could be difficult for them, which is why the Academic All-American, which requires you to be a significant contributor to the team, which is normally a starter or a key reserve, it's almost exceptional that they're able to do, to be a starter and to like be a contributing part of the team and have high academics. My goal coming into Delaware was to exceed both on the field and academically, and I feel like I've achieved both. I've been able to play for two years now at center back and at center mid, and then off the field I've been able to maintain a high GPA among the team. I feel like it's really a product of the work that I've put in these past 2.5 years at Delaware. I broke my foot freshman year, so I have an extra year of eligibility through a medical redshirt, and I'm looking heavily into the 4+1 program offered at Delaware for electrical engineering. And I think if I'm going to be here another year, I can play soccer, I can, you know, be with the team, hopefully we'll make a run, and I can still pursue that master's degree, that graduate degree that I think will really benefit me in the long term. I feel challenged in the classroom. Ian pushes me on the field. My professors do a good job to explain things on my level, and like, if things are too easy for me, they'll give me a project or something I can work on, or get me involved with research somehow to give me those opportunities to better myself. I think more than anything, it's all about time management. Like, if you look at where you're spending your time, if you want to succeed in those areas, it's as simple as you got to spend more time doing it. For academics, if you want to be good at math, you got to spend time doing math. And it's kind of interesting to see that parallel between soccer and academics. If I want to be the best player on the field, I got to spend the time practicing. I got to spend those extra hours in the gym, stay after practice and run sprints. Like, it's that time, that commitment that really will enable you to be successful. Nothing, I believe, is gifted. There's no such thing. There's natural talent maybe to a certain extent, but the players that the best are in the world are simply the players that have spent the most time doing what they love. It's hard, and sometimes you're up late at night studying, and the last thing you want to do after a game, especially if you lose, is to stay up that night and study for an exam the next day, or get that homework assignment done that's due the next day. It's so easy to say, you know what, I did enough, like, you know, I can just stop here, like, I'm satisfied. But for me, it's always about, you know, I could push myself, like, how can I fit all of this stuff in? Because I know and I believe that I can be good at both of these things. I can excel at both of these things. It's about managing my time properly, so I focus on the important things. My whole family's proud. My mom emailed all my relatives, and they contacted me and stuff, and it was great to feel their support. But really, it's an honor to be part of it. Hopefully next year I can improve on that. I'm always about bettering myself and trying to go to the next level, and I'm on the third team, so that means there's still room for improvement.